let us start with the welding safety. So welding means is nothing but joining two pieces of metals by using heat, pressure, or by using both heat and pressure. So as you know, metal cutting is mainly done by heating the metal with flame, and we are directing a stream of pure oxygen along the line to be cut. In this way, the welding process is carried. So the smoke that is emitting from this welding process contains a mixture of very fine particles called fumes and gases. So it includes various types of gases, and also which contains various elements which is very toxic, such as chromium, nickel, then phosgene gas, carbon monoxide gas, nitrogen oxides, etc. So which can contaminate the air. So the individual components of welding smoke can affect the various body parts such as heart, lungs, kidneys, central nervous system, etc., which can create short-term effects and also long-term effects. Short-term effects means can happen very soon after exposure, and long-term effects happen after repeated hours. Then exposure to zinc, magnesium and copper oxide can cause even metal fume fever. So the symptoms of metal fume fever, it may occur 4 to 12 hours, and the symptoms are chills, thirst, fever, coughing, wheezing, fatigue, etc. And also another important point is that the ultraviolet rays that is emitting from this welding process can react with hydrocarbon solvents, and the end product can be phosgene gas, which is very dangerous and can cause even death. Let us start with the welding safety. So the studies have shown that always the welders are at a risk of lung cancer, and the various agents that causes lung cancer are cadmium, nickel, beryllium, chromium and arsenic, and they can affect the lungs also, which results in various chronic respiratory problems such as bronchitis, asthma, pneumoconiosis, silicosis. Then it can affect the heart disease, skin. It can affect the heart, then it can affect the skin, then hearing, then it can cause ulcers to the stomach, small intestine, can affect the reproductive system. It can create heat stress, heat stroke, then burns, eye injuries, etc. So the individual components of welding smoke can affect the various body parts such as heart, lungs, kidneys, central nervous system, etc., which can create short-term effects and also long-term effects. Short-term effects means can happen very soon after exposure, and long-term effects happen after repeated hours. And this welding process, from this welding process, can also affect the musculoskeletal injuries, that is back injuries, shoulder pains, carpal tunnel syndrome, right finger, knee joint diseases. So even though this welding uses low voltage, still there is a danger of electrical shocks, especially when the person is working in wet work areas or cramped work spaces, etc. So falls and fractures and other accidents can result from the electrical exposure also. So small shock can even cause the brain damage, and the larger shocks can even cause death. So always a worker working with this welding process has to use a dry gloves, then rubber sole shoes, then insulating layers. He has to protect himself from surface that conduct electricity. Then when working, especially on electrically powered machinery, he has to make sure the frame is grounded. Then keep all the welding equipment, keep insulation, keep insulating all the welding equipment and components dry and in good conditions. And he should not change the electrodes with the bare hands, wet gloves, or while standing on wet or underground surfaces. Then heat and sparks can even cause fires or explosions, especially in the vicinity of combustible or flammable materials. So welding and cutting should be performed in areas which is free of combustible materials such as trash, wood, paper, textile, plastic, chemicals and flammable dust, liquids and gases. So never the person should do a welding or cutting on containers that have held a flammable or combustible material unless the container is thoroughly cleaned or filled with an inert gas. So always a fire inspection should be performed prior to leaving the work area for at least 30 minutes after the operation is completed. And here the workplace should have a fire extinguisher also in order to prevent the hazard. So all the machines in the area with moving parts must be gathered to prevent the workers' contact, especially the hair, clothing, fingers, etc. So when repairing machinery by brazing and welding, the power must be disconnected first and locked out and tamped out so that the machinery cannot be started up accidentally by another person. So after working with the machinery, after doing that work, he has to put a locked and tamped tab also. That is, it indicates placed on as that instrument or machinery. And we have to prevent the trips and falls, especially keep work areas clear of equipment, machines, cables and hoses. And always we have to properly maintain and use handrails. And the worker has to provide sufficient harness, belt, etc. And he can use a scaffold also whenever necessary depending upon the nature. So always a worker working with this welding process has to use a dry gloves, then rubber sole shoes, then insulating layers. He has to protect himself from surface that conduct electricity. Then when working especially on electrically powered machinery, he has to make sure the frame is grounded. Then keep all the welding equipment, keep insulating all the welding equipment and components dry and in good conditions. And he should not change the electrodes with the bare hands, wet gloves or while standing on wet or underground surfaces. And always leave the gas cylinders and welding power sources outside the confined space. And the worker who is working in that confined space has to check the amount of oxygen that is present within the atmosphere. If the oxygen content is more, then there is a chance of flammable. And if the oxygen content is very less, then he feels difficulty to respire. So we should never ventilate with oxygen there. So use. You always have to use continuous mechanical ventilation or proper respiratory protection. And all the pipes, ducts, power lines that are not necessary for the work should be disconnected or locked out or tapped out from the confined space.